friends, welcome to our channel Trending Places. Today we will showcase you about Batu Caves, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Batu Caves is a limestone hill near Gombak, Selangor, Malaysia, with a series of caves and cave temples. Its name comes from the Malay word Batu, which means rock. From the tale of Si Tanggang, the hill was formerly known as Kapar Tanggang. The Batu Caves limestone formation is called for the adjacent town. The Batu Caves in Malaysia are home to one of the world's most important Hindu shrines. A joyful monument to Lord Murugan, who defeated the demons in Tamil Hindu mythology. Bright bands of color run the length of the huge staircase that leads to the caves. It's as though you're ascending a rainbow into the gods' chambers. Batu Caves is a limestone hill with three big caves and a handful of smaller caves that is one of Kuala Lumpur's most popular tourist attractions. This 100-year-old temple is located 11 kilometers north of Kuala Lumpur and has idols in statues placed inside and around the main caverns. The temple is regarded a significant sacred landmark by Hindus, with inner limestone formations estimated to be 400 million years old. Cathedral Cave, Batu Cave's largest and most visited cavern, is home to multiple Hindu sanctuaries beneath its 100-meter-high arched ceiling. Two more cave temples, the Art Gallery Cave and the Museum Cave, are located at the foot of Batu Hill and house countless Hindu statues and paintings. The annual Hindu celebration of Thaipusam, which attracts thousands of worshippers and visitors, is held at Batu Caves. The procession commences at the Sri Mariamman Temple in KL City Center on the evening before the Thaipusam Festival, which is usually held at the end of January. The procession usually arrives at Batu Caves in the early hours of the next day. The complete celebration then begins, and it is a colorful event that lasts for 8 hours. The event has gathered over 1 million pilgrims in the past, making it one of the world's largest gatherings. On big, brilliantly decorated cover discs, many devotees deliver their offerings, jugs of milk to Lord Muruga. Kavadis are made up of two massive semicircular ornamental pieces of wood or steel that are bent and joined to a cross framework that can be balanced on the shoulders. These frameworks are frequently used in conjunction with a variety of metal hooks and skewers to penetrate the skin, cheeks, and tongue. Flowers and peacock feathers are used to embellish the kavadi, which can weigh up to 100 kilograms. Visitors are typically captivated by the devotion of devotees, who get their bodies pierced by hooks, needles, and even skewers in order to fulfill pledges made to the gods. The truly incredible feat occurs when followers begin the grueling trip up the 272 steps to the summit of the caves. The trek necessitates a remarkable level of endurance as they frequently work against the crowds. Before the hooks and skewers penetrating the devotees' flesh are removed, priests wait at the top to sprinkle sanctified ash over them. How to get there? The Batu Caves are incredibly easy to get to from Malaysia's capital, Kuala Lumpur. You can take the commuter train's Laluan route straight to Batu Caves. Alternately, you can jump into a taxi or Grab Taxi, Malaysia's version of Uber. Either option takes less than 30 minutes. 13 kilometers north of Kuala Lumpur, take Intrakota bus number 11D from the Central Market or the Cityliner bus number 69 at Jalan Pudu to get to Batu Caves. Hope you liked the video. We have more than 150 videos on trending places. Do like and subscribe. Keep watching.